Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Pokémon Soul Silver Insanity Nuzlocke. In the last episode, we did training, which sucked, and I ended because I was bored. So these are the levels we are at now. So we're going to fight Archer, but not only am I going to fight Archer, but I'm also joined again by yet another guest. This is Zach. You may recall him as the first guest I ever had on these playthroughs, so please say hello.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Yep. So, yeah. He's the only one so far that's 2 months in a row, so... I don't know. It's cool, I guess. But alright, for Archer, here is the plan. We've got Antazza, right? We're gonna use him against his first Houndour. Then he's got a Koffing. We've got Altitude here. It would be great if Altitude knew a Psychic Attack, but we can't, because Zatu does not learn a Psychic Attack move by level up until 59. So, which is the move Psychic. So, we're stuck with Fly, unfortunately, on the Koffing. But the idea with Altitude is to get a Reflect up before Houndoom comes out. Then when Houndoom is out, we can use Skyripper. And that's the plan. Sounds also, good. Now that I'm thinking about it, Jaros might not be horrible because of his high physical defense.
Oh, yeah.
Not a bad idea at all. So I'll give that some thought. We'll see what happens in the middle of the battle. So, sure. All right, the final member of Team Rocket. I'm finally done with this stupid radio tower crap. Oh, you managed to get this far? You must be quite the trainer. We intend to take over this radio tower and officially announce our comeback. This should bring our boss Giovanni back from his solitary training. We're going to regain our former glory. I'm not even forward with our meticulous plans. Meticulous plans? I feel like that's not a positive word. maybe it is in his context? I didn't turn battle animations back on. Hold on. Be right back. Here we are. We're back with battle animations back on. We should make a counter throughout all of my playthroughs about how many times I forgot to turn that back on. That'll be really fun. So you cut out again. What was that?
No, I was just saying that would be interesting.
Yeah. Way more interesting than a coughing counter. And yeah, you hit yourself. That's very good.
Okay.
Wing attack. Yeah, I'm not really worried about his first Houndour. This is kind of just a warm-up. First turn, snap out. It's fine, I guess.
It's kind of even RNG-ish.
Yeah. All right, goodbye. That was one down. Two to go. Good. Coughing. All right. You know, maybe... Hold on. What was that?
You could take a hit and probably whittle it a little. Yeah.
I think so. But I need to have the Reflect up for as long as possible when Houndoom is out. So that's why I do need to go to Altitude at some point during the coughing portion.
Of course.
And he hit. Okay. And he is going for Sludge. The reason I think Altitude was okay is because he resists his only attacking move. So, that's why I don't think it's the worst. It's why it's not a bad idea to have Antazma out right now.
Absolutely.
And he hit himself. Yay! Okay, one more wing attack, and then I think I'll switch out. If he's an episode of confusion, I'll confusion him again. Nope, he's still in confusion. Okay. Didn't hear himself. Smoke screen. Okay, that's my time to switch.
There you go.
Perfect opportunity. Alright, we're going to Altitude! This is her first real battle. So, in her level ball, I feel like that's a unique ball to have. And I knew he'd snap out of confusion right there. And, okay. Should I put the Reflect up before I kill Koffing? Maybe.
You might want to wish right now just to make sure you stay at, like, really healthy HP.
Right.
That's a wish.
Yeah. And to people wondering about the healing rule, I think wish is outside of that rule, personally, because it takes a turn to kick in. So, that's my thought, at least. So let's start off with a wish.
It's weird.
What was that? Sorry, what was that?
It's like rest. It's weird.
Yes, it's weird. It's different than most healing moves. And my accuracy fell. That's not good. Try Confuse Ray. Yeah, we gotta whittle this down slowly and carefully. We're in no hurry here. Hit yourself. No. That's fine, we're gonna heal it back anyway. So, unless I get poisoned, we're not gonna heal that. Ha!
Oh.
Of course.
Wow, okay.
Wonderful. Alright, that's fine. No, that's it. That poison's gonna hurt twice as much because fly takes two turns to use.
Yeah.
Great. I hope this fly kills him, or else this is not gonna be good. Should I have put reflect up before I did that? Maybe I should have.
I don't know, we'll have to see what happens.
You missed! It didn't matter!
I feel like altitude wants you to put the reflect up.
Oh, I don't know how much longer I can stay in, though. She's dead one more turn.
Oh, shoot.
Well, that plan failed. Yeah, one more sludge and plus just a sludge, I think, is enough to kill me. Not even with the poison. If I use fly, I'm assuming I'm actually going to hit, and it's actually going to die. Two assumptions right there. Maybe I'm not going to be able to put the reflect up. I'm going back to Amtasma.
Yeah, I can handle the coughing. The only issue is Houndoom.
Yeah, I can handle the coughing. The problem is Houndoom when he comes out. Finally hit yourself! Good. So, Antasma gets a frig attack. Good. This should finish him off. Alright. Gotcha. Oh boy! Alright, last but not least, this is great Houndoom. We can't have you get in the way before our news of our resurgence reaches Giovanni! Well, I can't have you killing my Pokemon. So we're going to start off with a Confuse Ray. And then I will switch out. Since I don't have the Reflect up, I have to use something to try to get a little leeway on him.
Definitely.
Confused. Hit yourself. Yes! Very good. Antasma lives another day. You know what? Should I even switch out? Yes, I should. Antasma lower level than Skyripper. Yeah, go to Skyripper. You can do it! Confuse. Hitting yourself again would be really great. Ah, okay. How much does one Fire Fang do?
Hopefully not much.
Half.
Or, yeah. It's half. A roll.
That's why I wanted the Reflect up.
Yeah.
Alright, let me look at my stats real quick. Skyripper has 56 defense. Altitude is 64, but is almost dead. Jarvis at 128, but that's halved because super effective, so that would be 74. That's actually higher than Skyripper.
So Jarvis could get at least one attack off.
And Antasma 64. Antasma actually had higher defense than Skyripper. Do you think I should go for an attack with Skyripper or try to switch out again?
It's kind of hard to say at this point.
It is.
You'd really have to project it forward all the way.
Right. It's
at least dangerous.
If someone wanted to suggest I should have leveled up higher, sure. I'm kind of sick of having to do that, though. That having to level exactly to the opponent. And this isn't even a gym leader. There wasn't even a rule of leveling at him. I could have leveled past him if I wanted to, technically. But... So, yeah. What were you saying before that?
Well, I'm just thinking, like, if you're going into Jarvis, what are you going to hit it with?
Magic Leaf. That's not going to do much damage, so...
Yeah, so you need some other source of damage. So either Skyripper's going to have to attack and take the roll here, or something else is going to have to die. That's at least the way I'm seeing it.
Alright, Skyripper, we're going to have to go for an Aerial Ace. I'd love a critical hit and for him to hit himself. Okay. Neither of those. Oh! Shell Bell! That helped a little! That helped a little! Hit yourself. Yes! Yes!
Oh!
Yes! That's impossible! Oh! Not impossible! Improbable! Goodbye, Archer! Yes!
Isn't it like a 50% chance?
For a confusion hitting yourself?
Yeah.
I believe so, yes. See? No, confusion is helpful.
You're right. You're very right.
Oh boy, wow.
Doubting it.
Forgive me, Giovanni! You know, watch Giovanni just be like, I never wanted Team Rocket to come back.
Yeah.
blah, blah, blah. I will disband Team Rocket here today. Blah, 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 blah. And we're done with it for the rest of the game. Oh, thank God.
That was a close one.
Oh, you've already defeated them? Thank you. Your greatest nations have stayed Pokemon nationwide. Well, with Silverwing. Yay, now we can catch Lugia. Except we can't because legendary. Oh, I didn't think of Whirl Islands for Pokemon I could catch.
Huh.
There might be something in there. I haven't looked. But, I don't think we can even go there until we talk to the kimono girls after getting all the badges. Or is that only... No, actually, we just need to use Whirlpool.
I'm gonna take a look at this, because okay. I'm really...
But yeah, I told you guys the last... All the Pokemon I'm left to get, but... oh crap, poison. But yeah, there might be something... I didn't think of Whirl Islands. I was only thinking of paths ahead of me.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna heal everyone to their max, and then we're gonna get going. That was a great job, everyone! Great job, good show! Except Altitude, you kind of failed a little bit, but that's okay, it was your first battle. And you didn't... Someone decided you're not supposed to learn any psychic moves. So that... You would have one-shotted coughing if you had a psychic move.
But I'm looking at you, random guy in Nintendo.
Yes. Alright, how many items you guys could hold? Quick Claw. Why not? Someone have a Quick Claw. Elf, you can have it. Why not? What's the worst that'll happen? Alright, so now that we're done with this forsaken place, time to finally go back to Mahogany and head east. And we'll get a new Pokemon! Yay!
Very cool.
Yeah, we'll be getting Tangela on that route. Assuming I catch it. Big assumption there.
Can fill up the team again. It's so lonely.
You guys don't need to see me go there. I'll meet you guys back in Mahogany Town. Alright, here we go. Farm 44, guys. And hey, a red apricorn. Yay, I like red apricorns. I like apricorns in general. Alright, this looks like a psychic. I'm sure Antasma can handle it with bite. I'm gonna win for sure! Okay. Let's see if you can hold that... thought up. Psychic Phil. Oh, Phil. My Simipour. See, here's the level thing I was talking about. You can't physically get to this area without beating Radio Tower. We just fought someone in the 30s. 38. And now we're down to 27 again.
Well, because Team Rocket is just so powerful. I mean, they have to be stronger than everyone.
It's funny you say that, because I feel like the grunts are even weaker than regular trainers around the same time.
You know, you make a good point.
And, 29, that's a little higher. And it's a Kadabra, but it's gonna die in one hit, because it's five levels lower than me. See?
Yeah, that line is so physically frail. Or, just in general, I think.
Mm-hmm. Psychic Field. Arrgh, that's a shocking loss! Maybe you should be a better psychic, and actually predict correct things.
Oh...
Alright, I got a Max Repel. Ooh, a Fisherman. I fish until I can't anymore! I also battle until I drop! That's my relationship with my Pokemon. Well, that's technically what I do. I fight until we die.
Yeah, so, I mean, you can really relate to this guy.
Yeah.
Earlier in the playthrough, how did you get the ethers? You broke rocks or something?
I broke the rocks on Cianwood, yes. I feel like I may need to do that again, because I'm down to one Lepaberry.
Yeah, so I guess it's just interesting thinking about that, like, how ethers get into the rocks. Like, I just picture some dude in, like, this crazy hood just walking around and putting these potions in between a bunch of rocks.
I know, right? Because those are man-made items. It's not like they're naturally occurring, like berries. So, someone had to put them there.
Or some rich guy is just really throwing out a lot of ethers, and they just end up in the rocks somehow.
Maybe.
I don't know. It's just very strange, though.
Right. Alright, we're back out in the grass. There's an item here. It's a Max Revive. Well, that'll come in handy. I'm gonna search for Tangela. I'll let you know when I find it. If I find it. Oh, hey, we found it!
Oh?
That was easy. Alright. Level 23. We are 35. Let's go to Jaros for this. So we can do a not very effective Razor Leaf on it.
Yeah.
And he's got Poison Fire. Ah, crap. I hit you already.
Hmm.
I will use your power for evil.
Oh, man.
All right. So I have stronger physical attack than special, but Tangela has stronger physical defense than special.
By like twice, yeah.
So, Razor Leaf? Question mark? Don't die, don't die, don't... Okay.
You're fine. Honestly, I almost feel like it might be better to go for the quick attack here just because Razor Leaf has the crit chance.
Good call. I was thinking that too. Is quick it would...
It's similar enough base power because Razor Leaf is 55, right? And then you get stab on that. So that
and then divided by 2 for not very effective.
Yeah, so it's similar-ish.
If it dies, I'm blaming you.
Okay. I'll take the blame for that.
Okay, we're good. I didn't think it would die. I just thought I would say that.
Yeah, of course.
All right.
It's weaker to use Razor Leaf, but only by like a fraction, so.
Right. Okay, yeah. What ball should I use? I have a nice assortment of balls. We've got fast balls, lure balls, heavy balls, level balls, love balls, and moon balls.
Oh my gosh, so many choices.
Let's try a fastball. I don't think Tangela is very fast, but I don't know. None of the rest seem to fit.
Well, you certainly don't love Tangela, that's for sure.
Ah! I want to use a Kurt ball. I may have to switch out. Wait, I can't. We're binded. Okay, we can't mess around. I gotta use an Ultra Ball.
Yeah.
I can't mess around.
Yeah, because that Poison Bind is dangerous.
Yeah, let's just use an Ultra Ball. Hopefully it actually works.
Come on. Get in the ball, Tangela.
It didn't even shake once.
Whoa.
Oh my god. It's gonna kill Jaros.
We have another chance.
We're still binded. Oh my god. I'm tempted to run and say screw Tangela.
Yeah, Jaros is more valuable because you're on the roll of a ball right now.
Yeah. Wait. Screw you. Can't escape! That's right, we're binded!
Shoot. So it all is on the ball. It's on the roll. Wait a second, are any of these going to have a better chance? Is there any of these that get some kind of...
I feel like Heavy Ball's not... I mean, I feel like Tangela's not that heavy. I don't know how the level ball works, to be honest. Is it based on my level compared to theirs? Or is it just based on how low they are in general?
Yeah, let's just take a look.
And the Love Ball I know is good for crushing the opposite gender, and that won't work because we're both men here, apparently.
It says Ball for catching Pokemon that are lower in level than your own. Let me see if in-depth effect. Capture rate dependent on the levels of both of your Pokemon and the opponent Pokemon.
Okay.
If the Pokemon's level is greater than the opponent's level, then times 2.
So times 2, that's the same as an Ultra Ball.
Okay. So then it's pointless to use. Wait a second. If a quarter of your Pokemon's level is greater than... Oh, I see. If we were double its level, then it would be worth it. But yeah, it's only times 2.
Okay, so it's a horse apiece. But Ultra Ball and level do the same thing. Fastball seemed to shake a little bit more than the Ultra Ball. I don't know if that was just luck or what.
Yeah, I feel like that's just RNG because, well, I can look up Fastball.
Yeah, I'm going to look at the Fastball too. I want to try to figure this out. 4 times if used in a Pokemon with a base speed of at least 100. Does Tangela have a base speed of at least 100? No, he does not. So fastball, that was pure luck that it shake, that it didn't shake, that it, bleh, it shook more times for the fastball. That was complete luck. So our best bet is an Ultra Ball or a Level Ball. They're exactly the same at times 2. Let's go for Ultra Ball again. God dang it.
Please. Damn.
You've got to be kidding me. Well, that happened.
Yeah.
I have nothing to say right now. Try level ball instead. Why not? What's the worst that'll happen? The worst has already happened.
Yeah.
Tangle really doesn't want to be caught, huh?
Yeah, I wonder. I wouldn't think it would have that small of a catch rate.
Apparently it does. I'm gonna just keep trying. Nothing else to do. Just throw balls until we catch it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Wow. I don't even have a status effect I could put on it. I don't have I don't have one at all. Not a single one. Let's try a moon ball. I don't think there's any Pokemon I could catch that evolved my moonstone, to be quite honest. So, why not? Trying everything here.
That would be ridiculous if that caught it.
Heavy ball. Why not? Tangela might have had too much spaghetti. No? Okay.
Tangela in particular is heavy, yeah.
Let's try a great ball.
This is like legend level ridiculous.
Yeah. Mhm. Love ball. Why not? Oh my god. What a joke.
Just getting the ball, Tangela.
This is a complete and utter joke. Last Ultra Ball. What's Tangela's catch rate? I'm gonna look it up right now.
It's 45. And I'm trying.
I feel like that's not that low.
I mean,
maybe it's a little low. I don't know.
It seems to be kind of low as far as.
Got him in a level ball.
For comparison, it's the same thing as an Oros Rayquaza, which is, I mean, I guess it's supposed to be catchable, but you still have to do things to catch it.
So. Right. Alright, well, a nickname for frickin' Tangela. I got it.
You got it?
I got it.
Okay.
Is it gonna fit?
Let's see.
Oh, wait, huh? This is tumbleweed.
No, you're supposed to put threes for the E's. Bullhead.
No, that's all right. Tumbleweed.
Cool.
I feel like that's insulting enough to the point where, you know, he's just a freaking tumbleweed that just he just blows on by and just does. It really serves no purpose except being there.
Oh shoot.
Welcome to the team. Tumble. Oh my god. What the heck is this game? I'm flying back to Mahogany. Say goodbye to Jaros. I shouldn't have to say goodbye to Jaros. Do I need the HMs to get through Icy Path? Ice Path? Ice Cave? Whatever it's called? Because if I do, I'll keep Deadweight in my party. I think I need strength. I need strength. There's a strength puzzle. I remember that now. I do need that. So,
And there's really no reason to put Deadweight away for now, right?
No, I don't think so. Bye, Jaros. Your death was the stupidest death I've ever seen in Nuzlocke, and I've done a lot of Nuzlockes in my day. And why can't I take your item? I feel like just sometimes it lets me take their item from the move screen. Sometimes it doesn't.
Oh, from the move screen?
From move Pokemon.
Huh. Interesting.
But apparently, sometimes it lets me take their items, sometimes it doesn't. I can't figure out a pattern. Alright, well, Tumbleweed is now a team member. Sorta.
And it will inherit the miracle seed that it killed for.
No, right now I was going to have the experience share, because I don't plan to use it right now. But, yeah. It'll probably have the Miracle Seed at some point. Can Deadweight learn Strength? Because if it can't, I'm going to bring someone else to be an HM Slave, because screw having HMs. Yes! Mm-hmm. Yes, Deadweight can.
Go Deadweight.
It's really helpful that Deadweight's dead, or else I would be very hesitant in teaching these HMs. So you said it earlier, Deadweight is more helpful dead than he was alive. So, kudos to you, Deadweight, for being dead.
So pro. Oh, man.
Alright, well, that was a thing that happened. I feel like that's already enough of this episode, because we're already half hour in. We're probably cutting out a little bit, but... That was the stupidest thing I've ever seen. Like, well, there's probably been just times that have been just as bad, but... Wow! So, yeah, that is the end of today's episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Sorta. I thought I'd lose someone to Archer, but no, I lost someone to the wild frickin' Tangela.
Yeah.
Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. See you next time. And of course...
Rock on.